2 years ago, when E3D introduced the first products in their Revo ecosystem, I'll admit that I was a little underwhelmed. At the time, they had just two cold sides, their term for heatsinks, one low-powered hot side, or ceramic heater, and four brass nozzle sizes. Not to mention, the flow was actually pretty limited, especially in this era of super high-speed printing, and plus, what's so difficult about just taking a socket wrench and removing the nozzle? But right from the get-go, E3D was very clear. This is the direction that their product line is going, so get on board. Well, since that initial launch 2 years ago, E3D has been hard at work releasing not just more cold sides, but an entire lineup of accessories, and not just nozzles either. Quietly, without most people taking notice, Revo has grown to become less of a hot-end standard and more of an entire toolhead ecosystem. And one that I think is worth taking a look at, both to try and understand the direction that E3D, as a leader in this industry, seems to be taking as a company, and to try to figure out what the future might hold. In fact, on that note, even if you know a bit about the Revo ecosystem already, stick around to the end because I actually managed to get my hands on one of their next generation products, which is going to make one of the most popular upgrades out there 100% obsolete. Oh, and by the way, E3 didn't sponsor this video and they've never actually paid me anything. They did send over a bunch of products for me to play around with, but I was under no obligation to even make a video about them. I just thought that it would be really, really interesting to explore the direction that they're taking as one of the early and leading players in the industry and share what I learned with all of you. So let's get after it. To start off, there are, of course, the cold sides or heat sinks. Unless you're going to be swapping out the entire extruder, more on that in a second, you will want to start with a cold side that already works with the printer that you have. At the core, there still aren't that many cold sides. There are a few for Prusa machines, a bunch of Creality ones, and a Revo Voron, which is kind of a general purpose one that has been adapted to many of the different toolhead designs out there. However, what's changed has been the integration of Revo to complete extruder setups in a one-piece solution. Now, you may already know about the Revo Roto, which uses metal 3D printing to create a super lightweight, integrated, and all-in-one extruder and hot-end combo. But there are actually also Revo kits for the Hemera XS and the Bontech LGX. Already, we're starting to see a trend here. The integration between the hot end and the extruder to try to minimize complexity and maximize compatibility. Kind of like the difference between a custom built PC, which needs a lot of space and a lot of different cross compatibility, so you can actually get in there and customize and upgrade things, versus a ready-made Apple product where each component is designed to only work with each other component. Yes, the latter offers you less flexibility and customizability and comes at a cost premium, but in exchange, you often get a more compact and even often higher performance product. To add to the ecosystem, you now have not only the 40-watt original heater cores, but also high-flow 60-watt heater cores for those seeking a little bit more performance. This effectively quashes what I think was my biggest objection to the Revo ecosystem. Sure, there are probably still some other ultra-high-flow hot-ends out there that significantly outperform this 60-watt heater core, but overall, the performance is more than adequate for most normal prints and printers. But who knows, if this trend towards ultra-high-speed printing continues, then perhaps E3D will feel compelled to create an even higher flow, higher wattage, and higher power heater core in the future. Okay, hold on, because I do need to take a quick moment to thank this video's sponsor, which is PCBWay. Whether you need custom PCBs manufactured, or say you want to have a custom aluminum heatsink manufactured to add Revo to a printer that's not yet available, PCBWay has you covered. With great prices, incredible customer service, and super fast turnaround, they can actually help you with whatever challenge you're facing for your next project, from injection molding to sheet metal manufacturing, 3D printing metal, and more. And they have honestly bailed me out literally more times than I can count. One thing that I really love about PCBWay is that a real-life engineer checks and goes over every single order and then lets you know if you made any mistakes or if there's any issues with your design that might cause problems during manufacturing, and then gives you suggestions as to how you can improve the design so it comes out better. I use and recommend PCBWay all the time on my projects, so to support the people who support this channel and make these videos possible, please do check the link in the description for your next project. All right, let's get back to the video. Next, before we explore some of the crazier and more recent additions to the lineup, do you guys have any idea how many freaking nozzles there are for the Revo ecosystem now? You have brass nozzles, 0.15, 0.25, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8. You have high flow nozzles, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1.0, 1.2. You have both obsidian, or their hardened steel nozzles, and high flow obsidian nozzles for abrasive filament in each of those sizes and every size that you could possibly want. Though, if you want to splurge, there's also Revo Diamondback nozzles. There are high temperature nozzles that reach up to 500 degrees Celsius. There are high temperature abrasion resistant nozzles. Heck, there are even Revo nozzles specifically designed for belt or non-planar 3D printing. So whereas one of the original reasons not to upgrade to Revo might have been the limitation on nozzle sizes or flow rates, things like that, it seems like E3D has effectively quashed that concern too. I will say though, that at 3250 GBP for a brass high flow version, these nozzles are not cheap compared to the ubiquitous V6 nozzles, or even compared to the authentic Bontech CHTs. So it probably, ironically, makes sense to invest £20 more per nozzle in a handful of very good abrasion-resistant ones that will last forever. With that said, my only other complaint about the nozzles has been that unlike a V6 or Volcano nozzle, they are easy to bend and damage, so if your toolhead crashes into the bed, you're gonna destroy a very expensive nozzle pretty easily. Again, ask me how I know. Though, I guess it is better to destroy a nozzle than an entire hot end or an entire tool head or bend your gantry. But here, actually, I will say that E3D has already come up with the solution to this in the form of another element of the ecosystem. And that element is the probe. Yes, you heard that right, a probe built directly into the hot end. This is a drop-in replacement for the Revo Voron heatsink, which utilizes a piezoelectric sensor built right into the hot-end heatsink. Effectively, it can make any printer behave like the Prusa Mark IVS or the Bamboo Lab lineup, using the actual nozzle as the probe and eliminating the need for Z offsets and all that headache. But this particular means of integration is actually genius on a few different levels. First of all, it's genius because it makes it really easy to protect your investment of high-end Revo nozzles, which, as we said, are a little bit pricey, by eliminating the possibility of even possibly missing the Z end stop or slamming into the bed, thus doing away with one of the biggest remaining frustrations of the Revo ecosystem. But it's also genius because it renders one of the hottest mods out there right now, the tap upgrade, completely obsolete. At just £30 more than a regular Revo Voron, or £35 for the standalone washer, it's almost as affordable as a standard Voron tap kit, and it's actually even cheaper than some of those lighter weight CNC machined or carbon fiber tap kits without requiring any assembly or rebuilding of your tool head. What's more, because it adds only a small piezoelectric washer in the heatsink, a cable, which you can cut to length, and a small PCB, there are actually significant weight savings over even the lightest of tap kits on the market. Granted, if you already have your Voron running, you're not gonna swap out the entire hot end just for this added feature. But if you're planning a new build or already planning to upgrade your hot end, I can't imagine why you wouldn't simplify things and just get this solution with a high flow heater core rather than dealing with building a tap kit. It's honestly one of those ideas that makes so much sense, putting a probe directly into the hot end, that once it's been done, you really can't help but ask yourself why nobody thought of this beforehand for aftermarket hot ends. So what does this mean, and what's the bigger picture? Why did I do a whole video about this? I mean, I think a lot of us were surprised at the direction that E3D was going when they came out with an all-in-one roto extruder. And this just takes that to a whole different level, revealing E3D's long-term plans in the process. Now, I haven't heard any of what I'm about to say directly from any of my contacts at E3D, so this is just me putting on my MBA hat for once and dipping into the conjecture. But considering how spot on I turned out to be with the Bamboo Lab video I did a couple of years ago, I do feel pretty confident in what I'm about to say and my understanding of how these things go in the business world. So hear me out. At this point, I think it's becoming obvious to all of us that E3D is aggressively working towards building an all-encompassing toolhead ecosystem. In fact, as I was writing this video, I kind of thought to myself, you know, I bet that they're even going to start developing toolhead boards specifically designed for the Revo ecosystem, only to look on their website and realize that they've already done that. And this, I believe, really shows us the end game here. E3D is working on building a complete soup to nuts ecosystem of products that all just work better together, not just to make it easier to integrate Revo if you want to integrate Revo, but actually as a means of creating an ecosystem that's so easy and so comprehensive that once you get sucked into it, you'll never really have a reason to leave. And what's more, even if you're not that into the idea of quick change hand swappable nozzles, it becomes increasingly more difficult to justify buying something outside of the ecosystem just because of how well it all works together. I mean, to use the obvious and, to be honest, beaten to death comparison, it really reminds me of Apple. Say what you want about Apple versus Android and the walled garden, blah, blah, blah. I know, you guys don't really like Apple. But at the end of the day, one of the things that makes Apple so dominant in the US smartphone market, despite the high prices and honestly limited freedom and flexibility as compared to Android or Windows, is the ecosystem. It's the fact that I can airdrop files between my Mac and my iPad, or copy something on my iPhone and paste it on my Mac, or I can start working on one device and seamlessly continue on another. I can move calls between my devices. I can use iMessage on all of them. You get the idea. And this was my big aha moment. This was the reason why I wanted to make a whole video about this and see how my predictions play out. This whole ecosystem thing seems to be exactly what E3D is working towards. They want to make a comprehensive ecosystem that's so good, that's so convenient, that it just doesn't make sense to purchase something else, even if there might be a slightly higher performance or lower price alternative out there outside of the ecosystem. And now that they've effectively created every type of nozzle that you could possibly want, they're branching out. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if they start releasing more and more heatsinks for more and more OEM printers, ranging from Sovel and Anycubic to Elegoo and many, many more. Heck, they already collaborated with Big Tree Tech to create a bundled heatsink and Revo hotend for the Bamboo Lab P1S and X1C. And I think they're probably going to be working to make Revo compatible with more and more printers, particularly the ones that don't have a great or readily available hotend to begin with. But I think all that's pretty obvious. That's not any big hot take. So I think what these recent releases, such as the toolhead board and the PZ probe, have really made me realize is that they're going to be expanding their offerings not just horizontally across different printers, but also vertically into different components within the toolhead. I think that it's likely that we're going to see a whole lot more extruders and more toolhead boards to make Revo compatible with more 3D printers, but I wouldn't even be surprised if E3D started getting into the cooling game and came out with a CPAP solution or innovative new super high quality fans that introduce some new technology or improve performance. Or even maybe they're going to start creating complete ready-made tool heads for tool changer builds. None of this would surprise me, because if one thing is clear from the last 2 or 3 years of E3D releases, it's that E3D increasingly views themselves as a 3D printing tool head company, not just a hot end manufacturer. So that's it then? Is it time to upgrade all your printers to Revo? Like I said before, I was admittedly very reluctant to actually get on the Revo bandwagon at first. After installing it on my slow Mark IIIs Plus, I actually really didn't see the benefits. But as I've added Revo to more and more of my printers, especially those that had proprietary nozzles before, it has started making a lot more sense. In an era where there are so many different freaking lengths and standards of V6 nozzles, and more printers are either coming with a proprietary length nozzle or an entirely proprietary hot end, it is hugely refreshing to have one nozzle type across most of my printers and to know that no matter which nozzle in the lineup I choose, I won't need to find the appropriate socket wrench or adjust Z height at all when I swap it. And whereas I was previously a skeptic due to the limited flow rates and the lack of abrasion-resistant nozzles, Those concerns have all but disappeared. So when it came time to choose a nozzle for the new toolhead on my beloved Voron 2.4, I literally could not think of any reason to use another company's hot end like I'd done in the past. Especially when you consider that in one fell swoop, I could check off both the hot end and the nozzle probe solution with almost no additional work. And for the same reason, as I started planning my 7 toolhead conversion for the Sovel SV08, the only reason that I didn't use 7 Revo toolheads and just chose to do 4 was so that I would have the option to test out and even use some of the very high-end V6 nozzles that I've already invested money in. And like I said, I kind of get the feeling that this is exactly what E3D is going for. Like Tesla with their cars paired with their supercharger network and then the power wall and then the solar roof, they've begun building an ecosystem that is just so simple to use all the parts together that it just makes more sense to give in to the ecosystem. I've heard, for example, many people say that they hate Elon Musk and they have absolutely zero brand affinity towards Tesla, but they did their market research and they end up buying a Tesla just because it makes so much more sense than anything else on the market without that ecosystem. So ultimately, there are really only two reasons that I can still see to venture outside of this ecosystem. The first is that you're really looking for peak performance. As of right now, 60 watts is the highest flow version of the Revo hot end. And while that does perform quite well with the high flow Bontech technology nozzles, I'm sure that something crazy like Vez 3D's hot end or maybe even a Fetus 2 ultra high flow will have a higher flow rate. And of course, the second one is cost. E3D, as a premium company that does all its manufacturing in Europe, is not cheap, particularly for the replacement nozzles. While their hot ends or cold sides aren't particularly pricey compared to others in the market, if I were buying these products out of pocket, it would genuinely hurt every time that I had to pay as much as £5,250 per nozzle, knowing that a generic hardened steel volcano nozzle costs like a couple of bucks on AliExpress, or even that an authentic Bontech CHT nozzle is less than half the price at $20. But as with all ecosystems, that's the price you pay for convenience. An iPhone is more expensive than an Android. A Tesla is more expensive than a BYD. And more aptly, a Prusa or bamboo printer, which comes with the smartphone app, the slicer, the matching filament, the profiles for said filament, and all of that, is more expensive than an Elegoo or a Sovel. But in exchange, you get an entire ecosystem of products that are guaranteed to play well with the product you already own, and some sort of assurance that future products will be developed with the current ones in mind. But hey, what do you think? Will you be considering the Revo ecosystem for your next build? Or am I, as someone who uses Apple, Tesla, Bamboo, and now E3D products, just really, really susceptible to being sucked in by the latest, greatest cult or trend? Let me know down in the comments below. That's all for this week, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.